Hello and welcome back to my channel. In this vlog, I'll explain you about perimeters of rectilinear figure. So without wasting the time, let's get started. A plane figure bounded by line segment is called a rectilinear figure. A line segment, it has a particular distance. Okay, so that is called a line segment. And a plane figure that is bounded by line segments, okay, is called a rectilinear figure. Thus, a triangle, a rectangle, a square, a pentagon, they all are rectilinear figure. But a circle is not a rectilinear figure. Why? Because it is not a line segment. Okay. Now, perimeter of a rectilinear figure. I'll explain you about different perimeters of rectilinear figure one by one. So without wasting the time, let's move forward. So perimeter of a triangle. How to find out a perimeter of a triangle? Perimeter of triangle ABC is equal to, as on right hand side you can see one figure, triangle A, B and C. So you will add all the three line segments like AB plus BC plus CA. Okay. And then after adding, you will get the perimeter of triangle A, B and C. Okay. Now let's take an example. Find the perimeter of a triangle whose sides are, now their measurement is given. Okay. And we all know in a triangle, there are three sides. So three sides measurement is given in an example. Like one side is of 7 centimeter, second side 8.5 centimeter and third side is of 9.3 centimeter. So how to find out the perimeter of a triangle? You will just note down all the three measurements. Okay. And then add, and after adding, you will get the answer. Okay. So perimeter of a given triangle is equal to 7 plus 8.5 plus 9.3 centimeter. And after adding, you will get the perimeter of a triangle, that is 24.8 centimeter. Now, how to find out perimeter of a rectangle? We all know in a rectangle, there are four sides and opposite sides are parallel and equal. Okay, so perimeter of a rectangle ABCD is equal to AB plus BC plus CD plus DA. It means you have to add all the four sides, and we all know that opposite sides are equal and parallel. Okay, so it means if AB is 5 centimeter, then CD is also of 5 centimeter. So perimeter is equal to 2 times of length plus breadth. Okay. Now, I'll explain you this with the help of an example. Find the perimeter of a rectangle whose length is 28 centimeter and breadth is 17 centimeter. And we all know that in a rectangle, opposite sides are parallel and equal. Okay. It has length as well as breadth also. So, perimeter of a rectangle is equal to 2 times of length plus breadth. What is the length is in this example? 28 centimeter. It means 2 times of, means 2 multiply by 28 plus breadth is 17 centimeter. Okay. So, first you will add 28 plus 17 means you will add length as well as breadth, and whatever comes you just multiply with it with the 2. Okay. And what you will get after multiplying 245 is 90. So perimeter of a rectangle is 90 centimeter. Then perimeter of a square. Perimeter of a square is equal to 4 into side, and we all know in a square all the 4 sides are equal. So there is no need of writing all the 4 sides 4 times. Just write measurement, whatever is the measurement at once, and multiply with the 4. Why? Because all 4 sides are equal, and in a square there are only 4 sides. Okay. Therefore side of a square is equal to 1 upon 4 into its perimeter. So this is the formula for finding out the side of a square. Now let's take an example. Find the perimeter of a square each of whose sides measures 16 cm. Means in a square there are 4 sides, and what is the measurement of each side? It measures 16 centimeter each. Okay, so each side of a square is equal to 16 centimeter. So what will be the perimeter of a square? 4 into 16, and you will get 64 centimeter. So this is the perimeter of a square. So this is the end of the vlog. Hope you like it, and if so, then please do like, share and subscribe to my channel. Thanks for watching.